Hello, traders. Thank you for watching the Slow Stochastic Reloaded Part 1, Part 2, and Part 3. This is Part 4. If you have not yet watched Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, you may do so before watching this. This video is for educational purposes only. It's neither a solicitation or an offer to buy or sell any financial instrument. And it is primarily for the TSTWSYS08 traders. We encourage traders to watch all reloaded stochastic because each video reveals a specific trading.
Thank you for watching. This is Stochastic Reloaded Part 4. All right, I hope you have watched Stochastic Reloaded Part 1, Part 2, Part 3. Okay, if you have not, you may do so before watching this part. Very important. All right, now. Okay, as explained to traders, okay, before, there are 13, okay, Elliott wave patterns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 Elliott wave patterns. There are also 13 stochastic patterns. This is about the 24SP trading material, which you can purchase at www.stochastic-magd.com. 13 Elliott wave pattern, 13 stochastic pattern. But in this series of video talking about MACD reloaded, I will not talk about the stochastic patterns. I will talk about simple things that traders need to remember when they are using the stochastic indicator, the slow stochastic indicator. As explained 100 times, the price doing three things, as you can see on this chart. We can keep drawing lines on this chart, and you will see only three types of channel: rising channel, horizontal channel, declining channel. Three type of channel. We can carry on doing this all day long. You can check that on a yearly chart, on the hourly chart, on the 5 minute chart. Everywhere you go, this is about the market pattern, the three channels. The first thing that traders must check before making any trading decision is the market pattern, the three channels. Very, very important. If you want to remain in this market for a long time, one must be busy, okay, following the steps gradually. First steps, check, okay, the market patterns, okay, and then the fractal pattern, which is higher time frame, commands the lower time frame. One can perfectly use indicator. Now, by the way, trader asked me all the time, do we use indicator? Yes, TSTW24, TSTWSY08, TSTWSY008, all TST use indicator, but traders must give priority to the price. As you can see on this chart, there is this green rising channel. It's a bullish momentum progressing here. What is stochastic will do that time? Though the stochastic is horizontal in this case, I'm going to remove some of now bring it back again. Moment, please. 1 second, please, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I want to change the setting of my stochastic to 833 and also change the color of it to green. Okay, 833, and then I want to change it, this one also, to 3833. So 3, okay, and I want to change also the color to that, to red. In fact, I will change the style also to this one. And that's it. Okay, that's my stochastic 833, my favorite stochastic. Now, as you can see, though the stochastic is horizontal in this stochastic reloaded part 4, though the stochastic is horizontal going up and down, is highlighting the market patterns. It doesn't matter which channel you are in, the stochastic is still between the 75 and 25 level. 75 as overbought zone, 25 as oversold zone. We want to use the oversold stochastic when we are in the rising channel or horizontal channel. We do not want to use the oversold stochastic in a bearish channel. We will use the overbought stochastic in a declining channel. That's the best strategy. As you can see, if you draw lines, as I've done in here, you will wait carefully, as I've shown you already. By the way, this is no more the S&P 500, but it's the Dow Jones Index. Okay, which is mimicking the market, which is the S&P 500. It looks exactly the same thing. I believe you didn't notice it, but it's exactly the pattern, same pattern, like the S&P 500, which I was showing you earlier on the forward chart. You remember this session on the S&P 500, oversold? Yeah, exactly the same pattern on the Dow Jones, okay? Same market, okay? So we want to know the channels and use the stochastic carefully. So here, once we see a rising channel, we want to focus on the oversold stochastic. Price is going up. You see here, it's in a rising channel, which means the price is looking for a better resistance level. How do we know the resistance level? Because we're on a 4-hour chart, multiple time frame, nothing should stop us to be curious. You see the channel now, it's still valid here on a daily chart. We want to be curious, where is the next resistance level? Okay, where is the next resistance level? Some resistance level are hidden, which I talked about before, talking about the pitchfork tool, talking about the Fibonacci projection or Fibonacci extensions. These are the tools that will show us some of the hidden resistance level. But very often you will see the resistance level. There's a resistance level here. You see, we are in a resistance zone. You see, so we just be curious now, because we are in a rising channel. We want to know, where are the resistance level? If you are in a declining channel, we want to know, where are the support level? Price going down, price looking for a better support level. So you see, now we are here. As we are buying, we don't want to be buying all the time. At this point in time, we are now carefully. I won't take any more buy signal here, because I know now we are in a resistance level. We have played it up to the resistance zone now. I will stop. So you may say to me, George, why don't you continue to buy? Because you say that when it's a rising channel, I must always buy here. But buy only if you are not in a resistance zone. If you are in a resistance zone, look for something else or take some days off. All right? So here you see, it's clear we're in a resistance zone now. Okay, it's not worthy being playing this in a, I'll draw horizontal line here and wait for it to break above this level. Okay, and retest above it before I can buy. But now we are near it, I'll mark my profit and go and do something else until the market goes above the resistance level, break above, retest, turn around. Alright? You see now? So do not use it, like a science or like a theory. Bam, 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 bam. Okay? You understand everything else that we have said before, so you can make excellent. I'm talking like this not to annoy traders, but to get the attention of traders. Okay, so don't think that these guys are arrogant, but I'm talking like this to get the attention of traders. Okay, all right. So here we see that we are in a bearish channel like this. Okay, we do not care what the stochastic is doing here at the base. We want to concentrate on the overbought zone, which is probably pulling back near the edge of the upper zone. Okay, you want to sell, do not sell at a support level. If you want to sell at a support level, we want it to break below the support level to go back and try to retest the support level. All right, so you see again, rising channel, declining channel, look, horizontal channel. So here we would like to sell on top here. So we, in this case, when we have a balanced market, we'll focus on both sides of stochastic, oversold and overbought. But the market does not stay over, or does not consolidate forever. At one point, you break below the consolidation zone. See, break below this consolidation session. Was trying to retest it, but couldn't. You see, normal condition is they'll come back and retest it here. The blue line at the base here, trying to come up, okay? All right, so this is what though the stochastic is so the stochastic, in fact, is an excellent tool, because though the channel for the stochastic 75 and 25 is horizontal, is depicting clearly the three channel. You see, it didn't go, the stochastic did not change direction, but you can see the price is moving from one channel, you see, horizontal channel, declining channel, rising channel. Before that, if you want, we can carry on drawing lines here. What is happening here? You see, same scenario. The channels, okay, that's the key for successful trading. Here again, on a 4-hour chart, Okay, you can draw channels and make excellent decisions easily. This is again horizontal channel before thou a rising. Okay, channel. You see now? Okay, I want this to stick into your mind. I'm talking like this, okay, to get attention. So, okay, you do not just go, okay, and shoot in the voice, so to speak, all right, but you can aim, okay, aim, have a target, okay, know exactly what is taking place, okay, so you can make excellent, okay, trading decision. That will be the end of a stochastic reloaded. As I explained to you, there are 13 alien wave patterns, specific alien wave pattern. The patterns highlight to traders excellent trading opportunity, telling traders that something is likely to take place. All right, we have alien wave pattern, 13 alien wave pattern, 13 stochastic pattern. There are price pattern and also market pattern. The rising channel, the horizontal channel, and the declining channel are market pattern. They are not a price pattern. But the market pattern will control the price pattern. Apart from that, we talk about the fractal pattern of the market, which means the higher time frame will command the lower time frame. The setup, the signal, and the entry time frame. The setup, when we are talking about the setups, we are talking about the patterns. That's why the area wave trader have a bit of an edge, because they just know 13 specific patterns that they focus on. When they see the pattern, they do not jump on it. They wait for a clear cut signal to participate in the direction of the price itself, the number one indicators. Same thing, those who are using the 24SP trading material understand clearly the 13 stochastic pattern. When they see a pattern, they know that it's a setup. One must wait now for the signal and select a best entry point. Whichever trading method that you are using, one must understand that trading is not all about excitement. It's about minimizing the risk and maximizing profit. We want to enter a trade, or when we see a setup, if it's not perfectly set up, we can walk away. We don't have to take every signal, okay? We want to enter the trade. We want to enter the trade at a low risk entry point. If we are a new trader, we can slowly but gradually, okay, build our ability to trade by learning slowly, have a demo account, okay? Try gradually, okay? www.fscm.com, free demo account each month, okay? Practice. If you are trading stock, pay attention to the volume. If you receive a bullish signal, pay attention to the volume. The market first. When one is using a trading strategy, one must always pay attention to the trading triangle. Which means what? The market first, the S&P 500, the direction of the S&P 500, okay? First, then the sector before the individual financial instrument. The heart of the trading triangle, we have the leaders, the news, and the fundamental. These are simple things, but the bread and butter of trading is a rising channel, declining channel, and horizontal tight channel. We wish you the very best in your trading. And until the next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy. We are the TSTWSYS008 traders. Speak to you soon.